Hey, what's up, everybody? Thanks for tuning in. This is the remastered tutorial on how to use the camera and make a Maker dance. Some of you may be coming from my previous tutorial that wasn't good at all. I welcome you guys because this is the real deal, or at least I hope so. This tutorial will be using the most advanced version of Maker Dance, version 9.31, as of today. So first off, with a standard 3-button mouse, you can move the camera around in 3 different ways. Holding the right mouse button allows you to move the camera around in tilted directions based on where the camera is positioned. Holding in the middle mouse wheel allows you to pan the camera. If you scroll the middle mouse wheel in and out, you are able to zoom in and out like this. At the top right corner of the animation window, you will see 2 out of the 3 controls we just mentioned, but in button form. Left clicking and holding down the magnifying glass button will let you zoom in and out. Left clicking and holding down on the cross pans the camera, making it move. There are 2 hotkeys you can press while using these buttons. Holding down shift key while using these buttons will drastically speed up the movement rate. And holding down the control key will slow down the movement rate, allowing for a more precise angle or pan. Next is the camera controls found in the model manipulation box on the bottom left, just before the interpolation curve box. If you have nothing loaded into Miku Miku Dance, such as models, accessories, etc., the camera is the only option you'll see here. If you have one model or more loaded in, clicking on the drop box shown here will let you change from camera animation to model animation mode. Next to the model manipulation box, we have the camera box. The reset button resets the camera position to default. Perspect is short for camera perspective. Changing between modes causes the camera to either stretch the view of what is in the animation window, like this, or to enhance the focus on the model, like this. The further away the camera is in non-perspect mode, the more exaggerated the outline of the model becomes. At the bottom of the camera box, we have the Follow Bone option. You can click on the top drop-down box here to choose a model, and then you have the option to follow a specific bone on the model you chose. This is a fancy way to make something like a face tracking portion in your video without the tedious camera work. Next box to the right, we have the light manipulation. The RGB sliders change the red, green, or blue scheme of lighting in your camera. The XYZ sliders change the direction in which the light will be hitting your model. You can think of this as when you stand in front of the sunlight outside. Depending on where the sun is, your shadow will be cast in different positions. And this is how the light manipulation works here. Next we have self-shadow manipulation box. Clicking off turns off all shadows on your model. Mode 1 changes the way your model's shadows appear from top to bottom. And Mode 2 changes it to appear from side to side. The shadow range slider will change how much shadow your model has from less intense to more intense. Next, you'll notice the view box underneath the animation window at the far right. This makes the camera angle snap to different viewpoints, which are listed as front, back, top, left, right. A fairly new feature, called tracking, will make the camera move along with the animation you supply to the model. To use it, you must have the track button pressed and one of the 2 checkboxes checked, either model or bone. If you have the model box checked, the camera will move in time with the whole model. If the bone box is checked, it will move in time with whatever bone you have highlighted in red on the model. If you have selected all bones on the model, it will work the same as if you check the model box. Those are the basic controls. Now the advanced information. If you notice the red dot in the middle of the animation window, you should know that that is your camera's position. If I click on the buttons in the view box underneath the animation window and to the right, you will see the red dot doesn't change position in respect to the box grid that is shown on the floor. However, if I hold the middle mouse wheel and move the camera, you notice the red dot moves. You're moving the camera now, and by doing this, you can get better angles of the animations you create. At the bottom of the animation window, you'll see six rectangle boxes that control the angles and positions of the camera. Pressing on the X, Y, or Z buttons resets the positions to zero. You can also only manually input numbers here to move the camera in a more precise manner. It's sometimes useful if your mouse movements are not as precise as you would like them to be. For example, placing the camera at just the right distance from the model's face without pushing into the model's polygons. The bottom button at the left corner of the animation window allows you to quickly change between the camera and the model you last chose. If I choose Miku manually like this, I can hit the button to switch between Miku and the camera. If I manually choose Kaito, I can use the button to switch between the camera and Kaito because that was the last model I chose. If you know this much, you should be able to master camera work in MMD with patience, practice, and perseverance. This is the end of the tutorial, but feel free to ask any questions in the comments section because I'm here for my fellow animators. In case you didn't know, I have another channel called the Miku Miku Dance Resource here on YouTube that contains all the animations I've made since 2009, and a third channel called Sinless Rogue, which is used as a gaming channel. Links to them will be in the description, and I would really appreciate any help you can give at making more people aware of my channels. Now that I've shamefully advertised my content, I want to thank you all for watching and wish you happy animating. Oh, and of course, thanks for watching!